Recognising the limitations of the senses to reveal objective information about the world forced philosophers from the 17th century onwards to grapple with the question of what the world is and what science can know about it. Those who chose not to go beyond the limits of empiricism, that is, of what could be known through the senses, but who also accepted the relativity of sense perception, were drawn towards varieties of idealism, the view that the world is composed of mental images or ideas. Sense datum theory, prominent in the first half of the 20th century, for example, held that what we perceive just are collections of sensory qualities. The consequence of views like this was that the world science investigates is not independent from the minds of those investigating it. Alternative forms of empiricism, which are often lumped together as forms of scientific realism, hold that there is a mind-independent reality to which science gives us access, but that it's not directly accessible via our sensory systems. On these views, our direct epistemic access to sense data provides the occasion for producing scientific hypotheses about underlying unobservable entities and processes, and about how they relate to the phenomena observable by the senses. The question is where those ideas for unobservable entities come from. If not from the senses, in what sense is empiricism true? Further problems arise for specifying what epistemic attitude we should have towards any particular scientific theory. Given that theories are frequently overturned and shown to be false, what sense does it make to say that there is objective truth in knowledge? Should we only say that science approximates the truth? How we can measure and compare the degree to which theories approximate the truth remains a difficult question to answer, particularly if we do not have a standard of truth within science by which to compare. The best argument for scientific realism is an argument to the best explanation. The predictive power and success of science could only, so the argument goes, be explained by the fact that our best scientific theories have managed to latch on to entities as they really are and not just as they appear to us.